Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people have served in the Australian Imperial Forces, the AIF, in all armed conflicts, and it is estimated around 1,000 Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander soldiers served in World War I. It is difficult to establish exact numbers, as the Army didn't record the ethnic origins of enlistees. Many concealed their background to avoid rejection because the Defence Act 1909 did not allow anyone who was not substantially of European origin or descent to enlist. By 1917, the restrictions against Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders were eased, as long as the examining medical officer was satisfied that at least one parent was of European origin. However, many were able to avoid this requirement. Rarely was a soldier's Aboriginality noted on records. One of the few Indigenous soldiers who had their heritage recorded, as interpreted and noted by the examining medical officer, was William Reginald Rawlings, known as Bill. Bill was born in Pernham, Victoria, and worked as a horsebreaker in the region. Bill, along with his nephew Walter Christopher George Saunders, known as Chris, was one of the many Indigenous Australians who volunteered during World War I, despite restrictions. On 29th of February 1916, at the age of 21, Chris enlisted in the AIF. He was assigned to the 10th Machine Gun Company and went on to fight on the Western Front in France and Belgium. Bill enlisted in March 1916, aged 25, and left Australia for France 7 months later as part of the 8th Reinforcements to the 29th Battalion. During his first year in France, Bill suffered from trench foot caused by the cold, damp, and unsanitary conditions, and was eventually evacuated to England to recover. Bill rejoined his unit in late 1917 and took part in the advance along Morlancourt Ridge. On the evening of the 28th and 29th of July 1918, the unit attacked a communications trench and successfully forced the enemy out. Bill was commended for his bravery and awarded the Military Medal. On 9th of August 1918, the 29th Battalion was involved in the capture of Vauvier in France. Bill started the advance, but was hit by a shell and killed instantly. He was buried in Heath Cemetery in France at the age of 27. Bill's nephew, Chris Saunders, survived the war and returned to Australia on the Themistocles on 8th of August 1919. Chris's son was named Reginald in honour of Uncle Bill. Reginald went on to serve in two wars and became one of the first Aboriginal Australians commissioned as an officer in the Australian Army. When researching and identifying an Indigenous service person, a place and date of birth can be useful. If the place of birth of residence was a location of an Aboriginal mission, this can be an indication that the person may have been Indigenous. Make sure to gather possible alternate names or variations in spellings that may have been used. Information on family members who may have been named on records can also help identify a service person. Occasionally, a manager of a home, mission, or reserve may have been named on a record. To help you get started, these are the names of some Indigenous Anzacs to explore. For further help identifying and researching Indigenous Anzacs, search the Australian Institute of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Studies, Trove, state or university archives, as well as state or local libraries. Share your World War I research on Discovering Anzacs.